You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
So we're going to taxi down to the runway then.
My passenger today is somewhat of a general aviation legend. John Wildey is not a pilot, but in 2013 he had to land a plane and the pilot died in midair.
Golf Oscar Romeo holding Alpha 1, ready for departure.
Golf Oscar Romeo, Squawk 7047 behind the departing Cirrus, line up runway 21 behind.
Squawk 7047 behind the departing Cirrus, line up and wait, runway 21 behind, Golf Oscar Romeo. Clear on approach.
Golf, downwind, right hand, 21.
Golf, report final runway 21, number 1.
Report final number 1, golf.
John lives near Biggin Hill and asked if he could come for a flight with me.
Golf Oscar Romeo with the left turn out at 2 miles, clear for takeoff runway 21, Cessna 2406.
Left turn 2 miles, clear takeoff 21, Golf Oscar Romeo. Are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
So feet away from the pedals.
Yeah, my countdown.
So we've got 2-1 on all the DI and the compass, so we're on the right runway.
44 information, Tango on 1021, at Delphi, fuel request, taxi forward, 200 plus.
Golf X Mike, taxi Alpha 1, runway 21, QNH 1021.
1021 and taxi to hold Alpha 1, Golf X Mike.
Airspeed's alive, T's and P's are in the green.
Delta Victor Uniform, taxi Delta 1, report ready for departure.
Taxi Delta 1, report ready for departure.
And we have liftoff.
Delta Echo Oscar Victor Uniform, ready when reaching.
Delta Victor Uniform, roger, hold Delta 1.
Holding Delta 1.
Form with a right turn, runway 21. Say again, mate.
A bit missed over there.
It's going to be haze, I think.
Yeah.
There's a bit of drizzle, isn't there, coming from this cloud,
yeah,
by the looks of it.
You can see it coming down, can't you?
Golf Oscar Romeo, south of Beam 7 Oaks, 2200. Would like to change to Farnborough Radar 123.225.
Golf Oscar Romeo, Squawk 7000, free call Farnborough, goodbye.
Squawk 7000, see you later, Golf Oscar Romeo. Okay. In fact, I'm wondering whether it's even worth talking to them, to be honest, but we've got them tuned in.
Yeah. Well, they've got listening out, haven't you?
We've got visibility, good visibility, so...
Yeah.
I'm not overly stressed about it. So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard. It's the Flying Reporter back in the air with a very distinguished passenger here. John Wildey is aboard, former RAF clerk, who has a rather interesting story to tell. You may have heard his name. You may be thinking, who's John Wildey? John, you're quite famous, aren't you?
Well, amongst a small circle, yeah.
Amongst a small circle. Now, John was a passenger in a Cessna-like aircraft with a very good friend of his. And sadly, his friend died at the controls of the aircraft. And John, who I don't believe had flown very much at all before, certainly didn't have a license. I think you'd handled the plane, but that was about it.
Yeah, that's right.
Had to get back down on the ground. Tell us the story, John.
Well, it was about 5:30. We took off from Skegness at 5:30, and we'd been travelling for about 1/4 hour. We'd gone past the speedway track, and he suddenly started hyperventilating. So I said, what's up, mate? He says, I don't know, I don't feel very well. He says, just hold her steady. So I took control. And then he sort of came back and he said it was all right. So
he went on
a bit further. And he did it again. This time, though, he went straight out, threw his head back. And that was it. And he'd gone. But I thought maybe he was just unconscious in a coma. And not being a doctor, I wouldn't know the difference.
No, of course not.
So I thought, well, I'd better do something about it. And I pressed a button and called Mayday, Mayday, Mayday.
John didn't know how to change radio frequencies or how to operate the transponder. It was decided that he would try to land at Humberside. He managed to find the airport, but by now the sun was setting. It was getting dark in the cockpit, and John didn't know how to turn on the interior lights.
So you were in the dark, you couldn't see your instruments?
No. All I could see was the lights of the buildings around me. Yeah.
A helicopter rescue crew was scrambled to try and help John. Humberside wanted him to land on the short runway because the wind favoured it. But there was a problem.
This wasn't lit. And by now you couldn't see the ground properly. The grass was dark, the runway was dark, and I hadn't a clue. The only place I knew where it was where the lights crossed the runway.
But there must have been fear at some point, John, that I've never done this before. How am I going to do this? Or did you having watched your friend do it so many times,
well, I've been
did you think you
few.
Could do it?
I knew what to do roughly as a plane.
There's traffic. Well done.
He's at 4:30 now.
I'm going to come round this way, continue the turn.
Yeah, okay. You should sight him, he's probably at 6:00. He's on our same height as well.
Yeah, there he is.
Got him?
Yeah, he's away now.
Oh, I like it when the pilot knows where he is.
So what were we saying? We were saying, yeah, did you think you could land it?
I didn't really think I could do it.
No. Had he affected the control, when he slumped, had he affected the controls? Or
no, he slumped backwards, luckily.
Slumped backwards, right.
And his feet were off the pedals. But I couldn't reach the pedals.
Because your seat was all the way back.
Yeah.
Because that's what I do with my passengers. I push the seat back.
That's right.
To keep them away from the pedals. But
it.
Of course,
the
if they should ever need it, how are they going to manage it?
I'm flying John to Lydd. He's seen it from the ground, but wanted to see what the area looked like from the air.
Right, let's call in. Lydd Approach, Golf Bravo Hotel, Oscar Romeo inbound.
Golf Bravo Hotel, Oscar Romeo, Lydd Approach, pass your message.
Good morning, Golf Bravo Hotel, Oscar Romeo, PA28 inbound from Biggin Hill VFR, 13 miles to the northwest, altitude 2,200 feet, with Lima QNH 1021. Request joining instructions.
Golf Oscar Romeo Basic Service, Lima and QNH. A question, Mike is now current, no significant change. Now report with 4 miles to run. Would you like a right base or overhead join for 2-1?
Basic service, Mike current, QNH 1021, report 4 miles north of the field and request overhead join, Golf Oscar Romeo.
Roger, 4 miles to an overhead join, 2-1 left-hand circuit, score 7066.
Overhead join, left-hand circuit, 2-1, squawk 7066, Golf Oscar Romeo. Golf Oscar Romeo is overhead 1,500 feet, ready for descent.
Oscar Romeo, descend and report downwind for 2-1.
Descend and report downwind for 2-1, Golf Oscar Romeo.
After landing, over a cup of tea, John and I continued to discuss his dramatic adventure. He told me he made 4 aborted approaches at Humberside in the dark, and at one point, while climbing, he managed to stall the plane.
I tried to climb with no throttle, and it was quite a fair height up at the time, because I'd done one round, go round, and obviously wasn't good enough. And suddenly the port wing, left wing, dropped. And I saw this farmhouse going round like that. And I still think to this day that my friend was with me in the spirit, if not in body, and that he helped me get out. Because I don't know how I did it, but I just came out of it.
Because you were in a stall spin situation,
yeah.
There, which usually at those kind of heights ends fatally in itself,
yeah.
Doesn't it?
Yeah.
You were very lucky there.
I was. I think, well, I've always been fairly lucky in my life. I've had a good life, I've enjoyed it. I've got some good friends, all of them.
Anybody in that situation, they've been round and round several times, must have been, you know, I would be thinking, if I was in your shoes, be thinking, I can't do this. You know, if you've been round so many times and not been able to. Was it getting better each time? Or?
Probably not. I don't know what it looked like from the ground, but it didn't look very good from where I was. The thing is that I was determined to get down, you know, because I thought, well, I'm not going to pack it in now. I'm going to do it. But on the last time, they were telling me to come down. I was looking good, and it seemed to be good. But then just as I went over the threshold, I looked down at the side to see where I was, because I was in the right-hand seat. Looked down how far it was. I could see the runway and all the rigmarole that was there, and looked from me, and there was a runway right in front of me. So I went down, and of course, I hadn't pulled the stick back enough, and she was almost a three-point turn, if you can do such a thing in a trike undercarriage, and she hit the main front wheel back pretty badly. There were a bit of bumps and sparks, and then of course I couldn't stop her. Okay, I was cutting the throttle, but I put my left foot out to try and get the brakes, and of course at that stage I went off the runway.
Are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go whenever you are.
Golf Oscar Romeo, Alpha, ready for departure.
John did come to a stop. He was unhurt, and I'm told the aircraft even flew again.
There's 60 knots, T's and P's are fine, and here we go.
They say a good landing is any landing you can walk away from. Well done, John. Air traffic control, the instructor who talked John down, and the emergency services who responded. Respect to you all.
Right, you have the controls then, sir.
John flew Oscar Romeo most of the way back to Biggin Hill, just needing a little guidance here and there.
We're going down, so just pull back a bit. That's it. Good. And hold it there. So you've got a very big up, you need to push down because you'll climb your...
Foxtrot 2, taxi
that's
to the pump,
keep that picture the same, right there. If it's up like that, we're climbing.
Yeah.
If it's like that, we're descending. So it needs to be...
Big approach, good afternoon, Golf Golf.
About there.
Golf, 10 miles to the southeast.
And any corrections we do are very gentle, they're not too harsh.
Good afternoon, join from the east.
Lydd to Biggin is pretty much a straight line 30-minute flight, and we're home in no time.
I've got him there,
yeah.
Over the trees.
Yeah.
Scout camp.
Golf, can make Alpha 2 if it helps for the traffic behind.
Golf, roger, then left to Alpha 2.
Left Alpha 2, golf.
Now he's going to clear.
Yeah. Thank you for that, Golf Oscar Romeo, final 2-1 to land.
Golf Oscar Romeo, runway 2-1 clear to land, wind 2807 knots.
Clear to land, Golf Oscar Romeo.
Golf, are you back to the club or fuel?
To the club, golf.
Golf, taxi via Alpha 4, runway 29 of Foxtrot 2.
Taxi via Alpha 4, runway 29 of Foxtrot 2 to EFG, golf.
Oscar Romeo, request taxi to self fuel, please.
Golf Oscar Romeo, vacate left Alpha 3, give way to the Cessna, left to right, then taxi to the pumps.
Left Alpha 3, giving way to the Cessna, and then to the pumps. Thank you, Golf Oscar Romeo.
Thanks for watching. Thanks also to my Patreon supporters who are helping make this channel bigger and better.
Well, that all worked out very well, didn't it?
I enjoyed that. Thank you.
In my next video, I'll fly an RNAV approach to Shoreham. I haven't done that before. Subscribe to make sure you don't miss it. See you soon.
So there you go, everyone. Flying reporter signing off for another day. Did you enjoy that, John?
I loved it.
You can't beat a good bit of flying.
No, that's right. That was a good bit of flying.
Sorry.
Steady on.